Do you need to manually update a WordPress plugin? Well, keep watching. I'll show you how to get your site back up and running quickly by updating a plugin using FTP. Normally, WordPress allows you to update or install plugins very easily from this area here, but sometimes something will happen and you can't access that and you need to do it manually. To be able to upload a plugin via FTP, first you need an FTP client. I'll be using FileZilla for this video, but there are several that you can choose from. The next thing you want to do is you need to get the login credentials for your FTP, and usually you can find that from your hosting provider, either email them or you should be able to find that in your information from your cPanel. So the first thing we want to do is we need to remove that old plugin that's causing us problems. When you log into the backend of your WordPress website, go to WP Content, go to the plugins area, and select the plugin folder that's causing the problems. Let's go ahead and rename it. You can rename it to anything. I usually like to just say old, so I know it's the old plugin. Once it's renamed, let's go ahead and right click and download it in case we need it later. Depending on how large it is, it might take a little bit of time to download for you. Great. Once that's downloaded and you know you have the copy, let's go ahead and delete that. And that is removed from our website. Again, depending on how large it is, it might take a little bit of time. Once we see it's deleted, let's head back over to our WordPress dashboard. We want to make sure that it's also deactivated. So I'm in my plugins area, and when it's deactivated, it'll give you an indicator up here saying that it has been deactivated because the file doesn't exist. We've now removed it from our site. If you were not able to get into your admin area before because of the issue, you should now be able to get there. So now what we need to do is download the plugin and upload it through our FTP. If it's in the WordPress repository, simply go to wordpress.org. We're looking for the plugins area and search for the plugin that we need to upload. Once you find it, look on the page for download, and you want to download that locally to your computer. You see there's my old one, so we're going to download the new one. You need to open that file up and you need to extract it. Choose where you want to see it and click extract. When you extract the files, make sure that it doesn't extract into a new folder. In other words, I have WP Forms Lite and WP Forms Lite. I want it in the main folder before uploading. So just make sure that that doesn't happen. All right, now that it's in a folder, we need to upload this folder to the backend of our website. So let's go back to our FileZilla. And this is the folder area. You may have to right click refresh to see the older ones. That's our old one that we don't want. Here's our new one. So what you can do is make sure you're in the plugins folder on the right, and on the left, simply right click and upload. And that will go through the process of uploading the plugin to your site. Great. Once that's uploaded, now you can go back to the back end of your website. Let's click refresh. And once you hit refresh, you should see it here. The final thing you need to do is it's been uploaded, but it hasn't been activated yet. So let's activate the plugin. And now you see the plugin active on your site again. So that's a really quick and easy way to upload a file via FTP. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.